Workout, dear students of class 12th, let us start today's topic, When Autumn Came. It is a poem by Faiz Ahmed Faiz. You know he was born in Sialkot, Punjab, now Pakistan in 1911 and passed away in 1984. You know this poem is based on the theme, No Patience for Helpless. No patience for, no mercy for deprived people, or impact of autumn on trees, or tyranny of imperialist powers on subjugated countries, or people of subjugated countries. It is also based on the theme cruelty of autumn. Dear students, let us know a few things about the poet Faiz Ahmed Faiz. You know, he is a famous revolutionary Urdu poet. He was a lyric poet. He has been widely translated into English and other languages. You know, born in Sialkot, Pakistan, he lectured at Amritsar. He participated in the Indian labor movement, Hindustani Mazdoor Tariq. Later, after partition of Hindustan, he worked as an editor of the Pakistan Times. His famous poetic volumes include Lamentation, which means Nauha in Urdu, or Faryad and Fingers of Breeze. Lamentation won him Nobel Prize. Now, dear students, now let us turn to our presented today's topic, When Autumn Came. Let me read for you people. This is the way when autumn came to the trees. It stripped them down to the skin, left their ebony bodies naked. It shook out their hearts, the yellow leaves, scattered them over the ground. Anyone could trample them out of shape, undisturbed by a single moon of protest. The birds that herald dreams were exiled from their song, each voice torn out of its throat. Yes, dear students, they dropped into the dust even before the hunter strung his bow. Oh God of May, have mercy, bless these withered bodies with the passion of your resurrection. Make their dead veins flow with their blood again. Give some tree the gift of green again. Let one bird sing. Yes, dear students, let us now try to understand. This is the way that autumn came to the trees. It means autumn came to the trees like this. It stripped them down to the skin. Autumn removed all leaves of the trees. So it is a sign of cruelty. Dear people, dear students, here autumn is personified. It is given a tribute of human beings. It is personified as a tyrant. As a tyrant on the tree leaves. You know, stripped down, it means made naked. Like imperialist powers, made tyranny showed their cruelty on innocent people of the subjugated country. It stripped them down to the skin, left their ebony bodies naked. Ebony means black trunk of trees. It left the black trunk of trees naked. Yes. It shook out their hearts, the yellow leaves. Autumn, it shook out their hearts. It jolted their hearts. It jolted their hearts. Here, hearts, you know, hearts belong to human beings. So again, here it is an instance of personification. Yes, it shook out their hearts. It shook out the hearts of the trees. The yellow leaves, their yellow leaves, scattered them over the ground. The yellow leaves, they fell down on the ground, on the soil, and they got scattered. Om patte kidhar udhar bikhar gaye zameen par. It means they remained of no value. They remained powerless. Anyone could trample them out of shape, undisturbed by a single moon of protest. Anyone could crush them and deform them and de-shape them. Yani koi bhi unko paon tale rond sakta hai aur unki shakal ko badal sakta hai. Undisturbed by a single moon of protest. There is no one who can protest. वो जो एहतजाज की आवाज़ उठा सकता है. मून यू नो इट मीन्स क्राई. सो दे लीव द लेफ्ट ऑन दिस ग्राउंड एज दे आर. नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द बर्ड्स दैट हेराल्ड ड्रीम्स, द बर्ड्स परिंदे जो फोरकास्ट करते हैं, ऐलान करते हैं. हेराल्ड मीन्स फोरकास्ट. All they symbolize dreams. They were exiled from their song. They were expelled. It means they could not sing their songs. Their voice was crushed. Each voice torn off its throat. The birds, their voice has been taken away. They cannot raise voice against the cruelty. Yes. They drop it into the dust. These leaves, they drop it into the dust. Even before the hand, they drop it into the dust. Wo gir pade zameen par garad mein, dhool mein. Even before hunter strung his bow. It means the birds, they fell to the ground before the hunter, jo shikari hai, he aimed, he targeted his bow. Yani jo shikari hai, usne apne teer ka nishana daga, usse pehle hi parinde zameen pe gir chuke the. Yes, oh God of me. Have mercy. Hear the poet. He appeals to God. He invokes God. Yes. O God of mercy. O God of May. Have mercy. Raham khao. Bless these withered bodies. Ye jo sukhe hue bodies hain. Dried up bodies hain. Murjaye hue bodies hain. Aisam hain. With patience. With tolerance of your resurrection, with patience, with feeling of your resurrection. Resurrection, you know, it means renewal, renewal of life and hope. It means rebirth. Yani unko dobara zindagi ata kar. Make their dead veins flow with their blood again, with blood again. Oh God, make the veins live. Make the veins living with flow of blood. Yes, dear students, give some tree the gift of green again. Let one bird sing. Give some tree रब, ए खुदा, ए गॉड, किसी किसी पौधे को, किसी पेड़ को, किसी ट्री को गिफ्ट, प्रेजेंट ऑफ ग्रीन दोबारा दे दो, यानी उसको दोबारा जिंदगी दे दो, उसकी उसको ग्रीनी दोबारा अता करो। लेट वन बर्ड सिंग, एक परिंदे को गाना गाने दो, ताकि जो जिंदगी है, जिंदगी का माहौल, खुशहाली का माहौल, प्रॉस्पेरिटी का माहौल, यानी जो फ्रीडम है उसका माहौल दोबारा पैदा हो सके। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस पोएम द पोएट फैज़ अहमद फैज़ ट्राइज टू मेक अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट वाज द इफेक्ट ऑफ इंपीरियलिज्म ऑन सब्जुगेटेड कंट्रीज, ऑन द पीपल ऑफ सब्जुगेटेड कंट्रीज, हाउ दे ड्रेन देयर ब्लड, हाउ द इंपीरियलिस्ट पावर्स ड्रेन्ड वेल्थ, how they exploited them, how they exploited them. He appealed to God, birds, it means people who can raise voice against tyranny. There were no such people. He appealed, the poet appealed to God to give the people of subjugated countries the power to speak, give them life, give them courage, so that they can gain their life, they can gain their prosperity. Yes, now let us try to do the questions regarding comprehension. The autumn season is characterized by a few things. Few things, what are they? You know, in a year there are four seasons: spring, summer, autumn and winter. Spring, the autumn season in the northern hemisphere is from September to November, and in the southern hemisphere it is from March to May. March to May. You know, during spring season, green, the trees are covered with green. They start blooming. They bear flowers, greenery everywhere. But during autumn season, the process is reversed, the phenomenon is reversed. Trees are naked. They lost charm. They have no greenery, they are naked, they are devoid of leaves. They are devoid of leaves. Yes, dear students, does the poet talk about all those characters? No. Only cruelty of autumn. Cruelty of autumn or leaf fall is mentioned here. What is the impact of autumn on trees? You know, the impact is negative. The trees turn naked, leaves fall, they are trampled. Oh, what happens to the birds when autumn comes? They set off, they bird, they set off singing. They migrate, they move to other. They move to other places. Yes, they move to other places. Yes, dear students, why does the poet invoke the god of May? You know, invoke means appeals. The poet appeals the god of May, that the birds are brought to life again. They are supplied with fresh blood and let the trees be let to bloom. Yes, dear students. Now discussion second, page 140. The poet has used images, metaphors that suggest violence. It stripped them down to skin, left their ebony bodies naked. Yes, dear students. Do you think that these images are appropriate with the season? Yes, they are appropriate. Like just like imperialist powers who drain the wealth of subjugated countries. Likewise, the autumn, it has no mercy. It has no mercy. It makes the trees naked. It makes the trees naked. It makes them devoid of leaves. Do you think these images are appropriate? Yes, they are appropriate with the season. What is the significance of yellow in the description of the trees? The yellow color, it signifies the strength of autumn and helplessness of tree leaves. The poet says that when the leaves are trampled, there was not a single moan of protest. Do you think leaves stay silent when they are trampled upon? When they are trampled upon? Yes, dear students. Does this simile here simply means comparison, reaffirm the idea of yellow? Yes, it reaffirms the idea of yellow. Nobody feels their helplessness. That is the helplessness of the leaves. Oh, it is very, very effective. You know, personification means giving human qualities to an inanimate object or animal. It is commonly used by poets to create images in the mind and to give their writing a greater sensory appeal. Sensory appeal. You know, in this poem by Faiz Ahmad Faiz, the first citizen, the poet has personified autumn. Who do you think he has personified autumn as? Why? Yes, you know, he has personified autumn as tyrannist, as oppressor on the trees. It makes the trees devoid of leaves. The trees have been personified as human beings. Surely. We know trees have been purified as humans, which are forced. The autumn has forced the leaf fall, and the leaves fall. When the leaves fall on the ground, they are trampled and are described as helpless. Now, discussion third. Reference to the context. It shook out their hearts, the yellow leaves, scattered them over the ground. Anyone could trample them out of shape, undisturbed by a single moan of protest. Now question A, who is it? You know, it here refers to autumn. Whose yellow hearts did it shake out? It shook out. It shook out the yellow hearts of the trees. The hearts of trees, they are personified as humans. What happens to the leaves that are scattered on the ground? Clearly, they get trampled. They are trampled by passers-by. When will these withered trees bloom again? When God of May blesses them with rebirth. Now, second, give some tree the gift of green again. Let one word sing. What is the gift of green? It is usually, you know, it is the green leaves. the green leaves. Who will receive it? The trees will receive them in due course of time. What is the poet asking for when he says that one bird sings? It means for arrival of spring, for a birth. What had happened to the birds in autumn? Oh, they have been exiled from singing. It seems if they had fallen to the dust, before a hunter aims at them. Here's dear students. You know, hyperbole means exaggeration to make something apparently bigger. Here in this poem, there is no example of hyperbole or exaggeration. Yes, dear students, let me repeat. When autumn came, you know it is based on the theme, impact of autumn on trees, or no patience for helpless, no mercy for deprived people, or cruelty of autumn on trees. It is also based on tyranny of imperialist powers on subjugated people. So this poem, it can be interpreted in a variety of ways. You know, Faiz Ahmad Faiz was a revolutionary poet. So most of his poems, they have a revolutionary color. In this poem, you know, yellow, it symbolizes the strength of autumn, and it also symbolizes cowardice of leaves. Here, you know, autumn is personified as a tyrant. Its tyranny has impact on the leaves. We do not bear the tyranny, and they fell to the earth, to the ground. And they are trampled, and there is no protest. There is not even a cry of protest. You see the birds. They are being exiled of their songs. Their voice is taken away. Their throats are choked. These birds fall to the ground. They fall into the dust, even before the hunter aims his bow. Now the poet appeals to God to bless these withered bodies with feeling of rebirth. Yes, their dead veins flow with blood, and he appeals to God to give the tree the gift of green again, or provide them greenery again, and he appeals to God that one bird sing, so that other trees, they can get induced, other people, other birds, they can get induced and sing again. Hope the students, you would have understood the poem, and you can attempt the questions like theme of the poem, the main idea of the poem. Even you can write the summary of the poem in your own words. Hope for best. Hope you could have understood.